very much. You have showed us a clear path to be happy, because stress is somehow relevant with our greediness, our ambitious life, our high thought, high hope. So these are creating stress. But if we become happy with little things, with mediocre things, what we have, and then obviously the peace is from inner side of our heart. Thank you very much for telling us this very practical truth, that please reduce your aspirations, you will be happy from your inner side. So my last question for this session could be how to have work-life harmony. So could you please state it?
Yeah. So you told me and we discussed that we should be happy with whatever we have. But it is not that we should not have big goal, big ambition in our life. Yes, you have to have a big goal, big ambition in your life. But once you set that goal, then you have to concentrate your efforts in doing the work, not the goal. The important reason why we are stressed, why we are unhappy, because of our attachment to the result. We have something, so we are attached to the result. Ki, if I have to do this work, I should get this thing. If I don't get that thing, then I will be unhappy. So if you have your attachment to the result, then you would be always unhappy, because our mind is never satisfied. If you achieve, then you are unhappy with that particular achievement. You want more. So you should have a big big goal in your life. But you should concentrate your work, your efforts at the work. And this is called as Nishkam Karma. Nishkam Karma means the God has given you the authority to concentrate on your work. Okay. There is no control with your result. If you do the work as an order of a God, and if you do not expect anything, then it is called as Nishkam Karma. And if we live and work like this, we can have a goal, but you have to concentrate your efforts, your energy to the work and efforts, not result, no attachment to the result. If we have this kind of attitude in our life, then we can have a higher goal, we can reach there, but we can reach without any stress. So this Nishkam Karma principle is extremely important. So the last part is work-life harmony. So we have said that there is a blurring of a gap between work and your home life. Your work has entered your home and your home life has entered in this thing. So there are two aspects. One is you have to separate these two things, which is impossible in this life. But if we enjoy our work, if we do not take it a burden, if the organization and the employee work together to make the working condition less stressful, healthy, productive, then the work will be a stressless job. Okay, so there won't be any stress at work. Okay, and if you manage your relationship with your wife, your partners in a positive way, then there would be no stress there as well. So if everybody works together, then they can enjoy the work and they can enjoy the life as well. And then they can have this work-life harmony. So I would like to finish with a poem from Saint Kabir. The Saint Kabir has said, "Jini jini binari chadariya, jini jini binari chadariya, kahe katana kahe ki bharni kon tar se bini chadariya. Sai siyat 10 mahine lage kon tar se bini chadariya. Sovat chadar sur nar muni ode odi ki maili kar dini chadariya. Das Kabir jatan se odi jo ki tyo dhar dini chadariya." Now the Saint Kabir was a weaver. He was a saint, but he was a weaver. So he explained the life the way the weaver explained. So he says, the body the God has created, it is a miracle. We can see it is a miracle. We can hear it is a miracle. You ask the importance of vision to a person who don't have a vision. You ask the importance of your hearing the person who is deaf. So our body is a miracle. So Saint Kabir has said the body created by God is so delicate. And God is created with such an effort. But with indulgence, with ignorance, we waste this body. We have so much of indulgence and ignorance. So that's why there is so much of stress. That's why there is so much of chronic disorder in your life. And we just the gift which is given by God, we just waste this body. But the Saint Kabir has lived life with awareness. And he wants to give the body to the God the same way the God has given. We are not the owner of our body. We are the trustee. The God is owner of our body. The God has given the trustship to you. It is your duty to take care of your body. So if you take care of your body with doing good physical exercise, eating healthy food, having good sleep, then laughing a lot, having a good harmonious relationship with your other people, doing prayer, doing yoga, meditation, living contented and happy life, then it is like that you are offering your body to the God the way the God has given to you. So you are the trustee, you are not the owner. And if you have this concept in your mind, then you can live the life with awareness and you can have less stress in your life. You can lead healthy, happy, productive, and more fulfilling life. Thank you so much.
Wonderful, wonderful. And you have perfectly said that where as far as my knowledge, two or three religion comes together, say the same thing, Nishkam Karma.
Absolutely.
Or according to Hinduism or Christianity, this is somehow relevant, as well as the Muslim beliefs. Muslim beliefs also said, you do your work. You cannot achieve the result. You do your work and God will give you the result. So everything depends upon the same principle that if we play our role with devotion, with sincerity, with dedication, then obviously God, Allah, Bhagavan, whatever we call, he will give us result. So if we have this particular belief, then no stress can overshadow us, because we believe on a particular power, on a particular spirit, on a particular God, I mean creator.
Yes.
Then he will save us, he will give us result. We are just for working. So with this short note, thank you very much once again for enlightening us from various aspects that if there is life, we should have work. If we have work, we should have some stress, but this should not be allowed to be overstressed. So there are some particular role of the organization, those who are employing the employees to reduce his risk, to reduce his stress. And the employee himself has some duty to reduce his stress. The partner of his employee, husband or wife, they have some duty to reduce the risk. Finally, it is myself who is responsible for my stress. It is myself who is responsible for my beliefs, my thoughts, my inner peace and happiness. So thank you very much, Mark, for your very knowledgeable and very useful, very fruitful session. Thank you once again. Hope to talk to you again in future on maybe another topic. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.
Thank you so much for inviting me. It was a pleasure talking to you, and